Chronic fatigue, trouble sleeping, always sick. What's going on? Well, maybe it's your adrenal glands. Hey everyone, this is Stephanie from Fast Track to Health Wellness Center. Welcome. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing so I can keep you up to date in the latest in natural health. So in today's video, we're going to talk about the tiny little walnut-sized glands called the adrenals. This is part two of a video series that I'm doing on these very important endocrine glands that sit on top of your kidneys. They regulate blood sugar, immune function, stress, and they make different hormones like cortisol, aldosterone, DHEA. So they're very important in regulating many functions throughout your body. So when they start to give you issues, you will certainly notice it. Some of the main signs and symptoms are fatigue, trouble sleeping. So you could be tired all day, but then maybe you become more wide awake at night. Also, if you're getting sick all the time, your immune system is really weak. That's another sign. Dizziness when standing, salt cravings, sugar cravings. These are all signs that the adrenals may not be working. And then to get them tested, you can either do a saliva or urine test for cortisol. You can do a blood test for DHEAS, or you can get a hair test done to see the mineral ratios, which will give you an indicator of adrenal function. But in this video, we're going to concentrate on what are some of the things that you can do with diet and lifestyle to enhance your adrenal glands. So first and foremost, you have to stop giving them the things that they don't need and want. And that means avoiding the things that are bad. So the first thing is stimulants like caffeine. Caffeine is going to artificially raise your cortisol. And if you're already having a dysregulation, it's only going to make it worse. And I know everybody is into their caffeine and their coffee and everything associated with that, but it does affect the adrenal glands in a negative way if you're overdoing it. So if you are having trouble in this area, I would highly recommend that you avoid or reduce greatly your caffeine consumption. As well, you want to reduce sugar or anything that turns into sugar, because the highs and lows of blood sugar regulation are also going to tax and wear your adrenal glands. So you want to eat things that are going to get you to the next meal without constantly having ups and downs. So, you know, you're going to focus on eating a better diet, and that would mean eating a little bit more protein, because protein is really important for making your hormones. Tyrosine is a very important amino acid that's involved in making catecholamines like adrenaline and epinephrine. So it's important that you get quality protein in your diet. Eat that a few times per day in a good amount. Also, you want to focus on nutrient-dense foods. One of the main reasons that the adrenals also get tired is because they're lacking nutrients. So if you're eating a diet high in refined foods and processed foods, you're going to be missing out on a lot of essential vitamins and minerals. So you want to focus on eating a whole foods diet that includes quality protein, like I said, higher fat content foods so that you can get from one meal to the other without having blood sugar issues. And then on the vegetable side, you want to eat a lot of vegetables because they have a lot of minerals and other nutrients in them. So focus on eating quality whole foods and not processed and refined foods. That's the first thing. Another thing is you're going to notice that you might have salt cravings. Well, in this case, you should definitely listen to that craving, because the adrenals definitely can use some more salt. If you are craving salt, you should definitely have more. Now, I'm not talking about iodized table salt, I'm talking about sea salt. Sea salt is actually really good for you. Mainstream information says it's not good for you. Well, that isn't true. I'm gonna go into that in another video, but for right now, let's just leave it as eat more sea salt, add more sea salt to your food, put some of it in your water. But sea salt has a lot of trace minerals in it, and it's good for the adrenal glands, so you don't have to worry about that. Lifestyle, let's get to the lifestyle factors. So the number one thing you wanna focus on, and this is a big one for everyone they're having trouble with, is sleep. So a lot of people are having sleep issues, and I've done an older video on this, and I plan to do more because sleep is such a big issue. But you really want to focus on the quality and quantity of your sleep, whatever that means for you. So if that means you have to make the bedroom darker and get rid of the noise, get off of your devices an hour or two before you go to bed, possibly take some supplements to help you sleep better, whatever it is, you have to prioritize sleep, because the better quality sleep you get, the better your adrenals will restore themselves. And by the way, it can take a very long time to restore the adrenal glands, that's for sure. So you want to make sure you're doing as many things as you can to you know, help them out. Okay, so next on the list. Now, obviously, stress is something that's not going to go away in our modern society, but there are some things that we could do. We can learn how to manage it. We can possibly try to remove some of the stressors that are in our life, if at all possible. So if we are going to manage it, you can do things like meditation, deep breathing exercises, yoga. In our clinic, we use acupuncture. Lots of people come just for the stress part, just to help them relax, and it really, really works. So acupuncture is a great way to help manage your stress. Exercise, that's another thing I wanted to bring up. So with exercise, you want to still exercise with adrenal issues, but you don't want to overdo it. You want to stick to moderate exercise, perhaps like long brisk walks, maybe light weightlifting, but you don't want to go hardcore and do marathons and tax your body even more than what it already is. But honestly, if you really have adrenal issues, you probably don't even have the energy to do very intense exercise. But if you're burning the candle at both ends, I would say stop doing that and just do some moderate exercise or just some gentle stretching or something like that. All right, guys, so those are the tips that you can do at home, diet and lifestyle wise. Stay tuned for part 3. I'm going to get into some very specific vitamins, minerals, and herbs that you can take for the adrenal glands. So please stay tuned for that. And let me know in the comments below if you are suffering from adrenal issues. Let me know. I'm very curious. I know it's a very common thing that we see in our clinic. If you need our help, please get in touch. We can help you out with this. And thanks again, guys. I will see you in the next video. Take care.